All right, what's going on, guys? So today, honestly, there's actually no one in the gym right now, which is good. Gives me a chance to really film and kind of like get cool different angles here. But today's workout is going to be a maximum effort lower. And something different about today is I'm working with a safety bar. So I'm going to use this. I've used this like twice, but I've never gone heavy with it. I did box squats with it, so this is going to be really interesting. I'm supposed to work up to a 3-rep max today, so we'll see how this goes. Yeah, that's all I got to say. I keep forgetting that this bar is actually 65 pounds compared to a regular barbell, which is 45. So I've got to take that into consideration. But honestly, wow, that feels a lot harder. That is an ego killer. Damn, like that was 295 pounds on the bar. And honestly, I did that for 3 beltless. That felt fucking heavy. Holy macaroni. Damn. So I'm probably gonna bump it up, put 315 pounds on the bar. So I'm gonna try and figure the math out in my head when I'm done recording this. But I'm gonna put 315 on the bar, throw on a belt, see if that helps. And again, just working up 3 rep max. Don't know what I'm gonna hit. So it might be 315, it might be 330, but we're gonna see. 295 plus 20. So I'm gonna need an extra like 10 pounds. 90. Am I stupid? I came 295 pounds plus 20, 315 pounds. His ticket, so stay. All you have to do is. Alright, so one tip with the safety bar squat is to really make sure you're bracing your core. And when you're holding the handles, I like to kind of push them in as I'm going down, and then as I'm going up, I kind of like push them up, kind of like pushing up on the handles. I don't know. It helps me out when I'm doing safety bar squats. And then bracing my core actually helped a lot on that set. In the video, it looked a lot faster and a lot easier than it actually felt. So right now I'm in that debating stage where you're like, should I go up or should I just stick with having 315 as my 3-rep max for today? Or I might just go up to 325 pounds and try that for a 3-rep max. But I have to figure that out. That's in the, you're getting that stage where you're like, it's like, should I go up? Should I not go up? Should I just keep it at what I had it? Or should I just go up? This thing's a real ego killer, because 315 for 3 is, sounds bad, but honestly, this thing is heavy. It's like, feels so much heavier. It's like, it's killing me right now. It's killing me. If you never used one, try one out, and you'll know what I'm talking about. So, as of right now, either I might drop it down 75%, or I might go up again. But only time will tell. So I decided to bump it up 330 pounds instead of dropping it down, or 325. So I put on 330 pounds on the bar, going for 3-rep max. You gotta push yourself if you wanna get stronger. So let's do it. Yeah, It's definitely a 3 rep max.
Woo!
Yeah. Oh, God, I'm clumsy. I'm clumsy. Fuck. All right, so I totally lost my train of thought there when I tripped. Let's, all right, we're dropping it down 75%. Let's get it.
Sick angles, dude.
Five, 280 pounds. Let's go. This might be a dumb question, but are you supposed to wear compression shorts under compression pants? Because I feel very, very free, if you know what I mean. Do people do that? Are you supposed to do that? Is that like a rule? Because I don't do that. But do you, are those the same people that wear underwear with their board shorts? Because I don't do that. Right here, as always, try to be different. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. And if you like the video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out, Cub Scout.